Bimidbar, in the desert, where 12 slave tribes became the Jewish people. Their story began when Avram and Sarai set off to the Promised Land. Centuries of slavery to Egypt left the tribes weak and servile. Yet we also read how God, with a strong hand and an outstretched arm, brought us out from servitude to freedom. God produced many miracles to impress both Egyptians and Israelites. The burning bush, the Nile River turning to blood, and the most edifying, the splitting of the Red Sea. Yet their celebration soon turned to complaining about the food. Ornery Israelites turned on each other and eventually challenged Moses. The largest rebellion was led by Korach, the subject of this week's parasha. Korach was the son of Yitzhar, a grandson of Kohat, a great-grandson of Levi, which made him a cousin of Moses, Aaron, and Miriam. Along with Dotan and Aviram, the sons of Eliav, and On, son of Peleth, descendants of Reuven, he recruited 250 famous and influential Israelites to challenge Moses. In front of the entire community, Korach questions Moses' authority. "You have gone too far, for all the community are holy, all of them, and the Eternal is in their midst. Why do you raise yourselves above the Eternal's congregation?" Moses' response is swift. He fell on his face and said, "In the morning, God will make clear who is in charge." The next morning, Korach, Dotan, and Amiram arrive with 250 men. As Moses has suggested, the earth opens up and in spectacular fashion, Korach and the other rebels all fall in, never to be seen again. As the dust settles, the rabbis wonder, what was Korach thinking? Why did he publicly challenge Moses' leadership? The Midrash suggests that this was, at its root, a family dispute about the Mishkan. The Mishkan, or tabernacle, was the portable desert sanctuary that housed the Ark of the Covenant. As descendants of the high priest, each of Aaron's sons and their families were responsible for a different portion of the sanctuary. The sons and grandsons of Kohat were responsible for packing all of the holy objects used at the temple and to carry the Ark. All the holy objects were carefully packed, and the Kohat family members would carry them as the Mishkan traveled through the desert. Among his branch of the family, Korach was the eldest, yet he was passed over for leadership in favor of his younger cousin, Elzaphan. Korach's embarrassment at having been passed over fuels his attack on Moses. The Midrash envisions a confrontation in which Korach proclaims, "I, by right, should be the prince of the families, yet Moses appoints the son of Uziel. I, Korach, shall dispute his decision and put to naught all that has been arranged by him." It seems Korach's complaint arises not from democratic or egalitarian motives, but from pettiness, jealousy, and frustrated ambition. Korach's controversy was not for heaven's sake, and it would not endure. While Korach's rebellion was quickly squelched, hurt feelings have sometimes led to cataclysmic tragedy for our people. The Talmud tells us that the destruction of the Second Temple itself and the exile was due to an instance of public humiliation that could have been averted. As the story is told, a Jerusalemite preparing a dinner party set out to invite his friend, Kamsa, but the invitation went to his enemy, Bar Kamsa. Bar Kamsa took this as a gesture of forgiveness, put on his finest clothes, and attended the feast. But when the host saw Bar Kamsa enter, he demanded he leave. Bar Kamsa was embarrassed. "Since I'm here," he requested, "let me stay. I'll pay for whatever I eat and drink." But the host refused his offer. then allow me to pay half the cost of the entire feast, begged Bar Kamtza. No. Then I am willing to pay the full cost of the feast, but please, I beg you, do not embarrass me anymore. The host had Bar Kamtza dragged from the feast and thrown into the street. Bar Kamtza stood up, brushed the dust from his clothing, and said to himself, all those city leaders, even the rabbis, just watched what happened and did nothing to stop it. I will get revenge. The next day, Bar Kamtza went to the Romans and said the Jews were planning a rebellion. Emperor Nero was furious and decided in that moment to destroy the Holy Temple. Korach's rebellion and the story of Bar Kamtza are both cautionary tales, reminding us that when the most basic human emotions are in the balance, we have to be the best mensches we can be. As Pirkei Avot teaches, let the honor of your fellow be as dear to you as your own. And as Rabbi Elazar taught, come and see what embarrassing others can lead to. Bar Kamtza was humiliated, the Second Temple was destroyed, and our people was exiled.